Howdy and welcome back to Thundercast, ThunderTech's regular podcast delivering ideas, insight, and innovation to the middle market. I'm your host, Craig Israel, Creative Director here at ThunderTech. Today's pod is another in our series of podcasts highlighting articles from our Marketing Trends publication. So 2019 is a milestone year for trends. This is our 10th annual report on the emerging trends, techniques, and topics of interest to middle market businesses. You can see it for yourself right now by downloading your free digital copy at thundertech.com/trends2019. That's trends 2019. So today we're talking about electronic commerce, or e-commerce, as the trendy folks say. Specifically how Amazon has become the 800-pound gorilla in the space and how their move into the advertising space and gobbling up smaller businesses impacts other retailers trying to sell online. So to help guide us through this topic in the studio with me, I have Madison Letizia, our communications department manager here at ThunderTech.
Hello.
Welcome back, Madison.
Thank you.
Okay, so you have written an article for our 2019 trends all about Amazon.
Mm-hmm.
I found it interesting that you start your article by talking about how it wasn't so long ago where people were hesitant to actually buy things online or to, you know, put their credit card number in there. And I remember, you know, buying things and being like, okay, I'm putting in my credit card. I hope I don't, you know, get scammed.
Yeah, absolutely.
But there's that fear's gone, right? Nobody cares about that anymore.
Yep. We're from the days of like Capital One marketing their credit card, it's like zero liability online purchases, to right now, or like I'll put my credit card in on any website because I know I could freeze that credit card immediately and just get a new one and there's no harm. We all live in a state where we're pretty sure we're going to get hacked and our identities might be stolen. So we just keep moving on with it. It's just part of life now.
Okay. So some interesting stats from your article, total retail sales in 2007 were 3.2% online. That jumped up to 7.9% in 2012. And then just last year in 2017, it was 13%. So this number is, you know, exponentially growing, and we predict it's going to just continue to explode.
Yeah, absolutely. When you talk to anyone around the holiday shopping season, you'll get a great taste for exactly what this looks like, is how many people don't even walk into a store anymore, or how many only are walking in maybe for specialty small businesses because that's something they believe in. But if we could have it shipped, we're more likely to shop that way these days.
So it's no surprise to anyone that the big player in the space is Amazon.
Mm-hmm.
It's quaint to look back and think that they were once just an online bookseller,
right,
but now they sell everything.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, literally, you can get just about anything you want on Amazon. But according to your article, the Amazon that we know and love and trust now is going to be changing in a radical way pretty soon.
Yeah, it's already started to happen. If you're looking kind of at the news and you're following along, you may see a commercial here or there promoting different products that they have. And that was common with Alexa, but we're seeing them start to talk a little bit more about their suite of business tools or their business opportunities. And we were driving not all that long ago, and I pointed out to a teammate, it was like, that is the third Prime truck I've seen just on this trip. And before, they weren't labeled as such. You know, they didn't have this huge Amazon billboard on the side of an 18-wheeler, but all of that has started to change kind of slowly over this last year. We're seeing more and more and more of them out in the real world, as well as just constantly being a part of our lives. So that all kind of comes back to the fact that they've changed the game. What they didn't have, they've purchased, they've acquired, or they've created their own. Specifically, we were talking about advertising. So they abruptly cut off their Google ads recently. They don't advertise on Google anymore for remarketing, display, paid search of any type.
And, I mean, that's huge,
yeah,
right? Because Google is the undisputed leader in online advertising.
Absolutely. So they just are going to do it themselves. So they're rolling out more services of their own. They're taking a little bit past that paid search angle, and they're going to start with that own remarketing, leveraging the data that they already have. And it just came out a few weeks ago that they're the third largest advertising platform now.
And so it seems like a natural progression for Amazon, right? Because if you're trying to sell things online, what's better than Amazon? People are already going there to buy things.
Absolutely. It's really thinking about it as they already have everything all in one place. Mm-hmm. So when marketers like us will struggle with a brand trying to get into Facebook and try to find that audience there, their audience is one already there. It's a gold mine. They're shopping. They're doing everything in one place. So you could sell to them, you could track what they're doing, and you could be done. It's a perfect ROI situation for an e-commerce marketer.
Right. So that's in stark contrast to other social platforms mm-hmm. we've seen try to get into the commerce game. Like yeah. Twitter tried to make e-commerce a thing, and yeah. as far as I understand, just never really happened.
No, I mean, Instagram, probably Pinterest, if we're talking social platforms, does the best with their shoppable interactions and engagements, so shoppable pins, shoppable images on Instagram, but still it's taking them off platform, and that's just another step you can lose someone or track or not be able to track all the way through. So here Amazon really knows how many people are shopping, what they're looking for. They have all this data from years and years they can leverage to remarket or put different products in front of someone who's a suspected buyer. So getting brands on board with that system right now, it should be an easy sell, but you know, there's some hesitation around how many of your eggs do you put in that basket and what's the best plan moving forward.
So how do you think this is going to be perceived by the consumer? Because as a shopper, I go to Amazon not expecting to be served up, you know, results based on who paid the most, but based on, you know, my interest. Yeah. So how transparent are they being with the paid versus organic search?
Yeah, that is a good question. I think we're all pretty much used to seeing Google search results where the first like two or three search engine results were ads. Sometimes it's the first five or six. So we adapt as the platforms change. We really don't get a say. And it's like every time Facebook changes their feed algorithm, people are upset for days and then we just adjust. So I think we will adjust, and we're not always going to see them in obvious places. So where we might see them on Prime, on when we're streaming, we might see them on, you know, the desktop and mobile experience. Could they start to feed ads into Alexa? Because they're already going to leverage voice search in cars, in new cars. I mean, some of them are coming equipped with Alexa as part of their assistant package. So how does that play into an advertising space? So they have the space to play with, for sure. They just have to figure out how to do it and ruffle not as many feathers as possible, but just eventually get consumers on board with how it's going to be.
All right. So one of the things that Amazon has done recently is what they're calling Amazon Storefronts. So as we're recording this, it was just launched last month. That's September of 2018. And so this is a all new and different focus on small business.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So you can see either side of this. They've been criticized for shutting down small businesses because of the beast that they are and of how easy it is to shop. Or you can see this as, you know, Amazon lifting up the small guy and exposing them to the globe, really. So there's two things that could be coming from this. But what brought this to my attention was a new TV commercial, and it's all focused around this small biz, a little flower shop. I think it's a real store in Michigan, so this is one of their real vendors online. It's set to like the song Let's Work Together, and it follows everything from this little shop, and it's really a fast, clever commercial, and it watches all of the cars on the rail line to the shipyard, and then you see
earlier point, you see all the trucks,
you see
right?
all Branded the logistics trucks. Yeah, you see all the trucks going through, and it kind of starts to tell the story of, like, you know, there are 20,000 small businesses on Amazon, and they're going to start to bring up these storefronts and serve them to people in a different way. So they're going to do things like a storefront of the week showcase and the meet the owner series. So there's currently a few stores already doing like these showcased videos on their YouTube channel. So you can see like they've started to launch this already, but kind of changing the perspective of them being this Goliath who will gobble up everything in their way and saying, oh, look, but here's 20,000 stores we want you to experience, and conveniently launching that and pushing it hard in Q4 has a holiday. It's written all over it.
Yeah, so you can look at the good side of this, like you said, elevating the small business, but on the bad side, Is this a move calculated to just decimate Etsy and small retailers like that?
It really could be. So Amazon, I can't remember when, but you know, they have their crafter side of Amazon that they already started to use to compete with the Etsy kind of audience, you know, that crafters, that DIY. So I think this is just another way to level up. Mm-hmm. So it's like, will we see Amazon competing with American Express for Shop Small Saturday? Like, right. how will this work now?
Okay, so let's look ahead and figure out, you know, what's it going to be like for the smaller business or maybe even the middle market businesses that we tend to serve navigating Amazon in the near future?
Right. So looking through where we are right now, all of the new information and the tools and features that will be coming out, we see this could go two ways. We could see that a middle market could approach this either all in, double down, make Amazon your home. Maybe you're not a brick and mortar. Maybe you are just an online. So kind of moving away from that small business aspect, maybe you just want to move in, build that audience as fast as possible. And really what you're doing is building within a rented space. It's rented consumers and it's data from only a singular space. And we see that as something that's happening now, but something that will continue to happen as people want to launch and scale quickly.
So on the plus side, you don't have to figure out all that architecture, yeah. And Amazon does provide a robust, you know, suite of tools for you,
yeah,
to really
sell. Absolutely. So everything that you could imagine that you would need to run an online business, just looking at their AWS services, yeah, there's a whole website just devoted to what they've been able to offer vendors and small businesses alike to build up their online presence. So thinking of that as this first approach, like that's the way that someone will go all in with a brand.
So on the negative side, the potentially negative side, like you said, it's still a rented storefront. And
yeah,
when your landlord decides to radically change the rules,
yeah,
you're stuck.
Yeah, and there have been some accusations and some claims that if Amazon likes what you're doing enough, you become very appealing and Amazon might acquire you or bury you. So you have to kind of keep an eye on the competition, which is also your landlord.
Okay, so that is a easy yet risky strategy.
It
what
is.
Else might businesses do?
It is. It's almost the complete opposite of that. You take your launch or your go-to-market strategy and you diversify. You are looking at Amazon and the tools and you fold that into your marketing strategy. So you can use their advertising, you can use some of their tools, but it is not your only retail space. You put just as much effort into growing your marketing and your brand in a different space, your own space, a website, whatever content marketing or social channels that would come with that also support this bigger image. That way, you're not only leaning on Amazon. It might be a little harder. You're basically doing the same thing in two places. For example, you might be working with Google Ads and Amazon Ads, but this way you have a little bit more control and you're able to have the power and pivot as appropriate.
Mm-hmm. So literally not all your eggs in one basket,
yeah,
so that if Amazon makes some sort of radical move that is counter to where you want to,
yeah,
go, you have an out.
Absolutely.
Okay. So then what's the bottom line, Madison, for our clientele, our middle market, looking, you know, already doing e-commerce, looking to expand, what's their best path forward?
Yeah, it's the same. I think we're always, as marketers, we're always looking, maybe just as humans, we're always looking for the shortcut, the fastest way to succeed, and that's our nature and our ambition, but I think it's the tried and true. You've got to look at your strategic and you have to make well-informed decisions. If you want to have success in marketing or as a business or on Amazon, whatever you're looking at, you know, you have to have a side of skepticism as well as, you know, having all the information in front of you. So thinking things through before you launch, that's still that tried and true advice.
Mm-hmm. All right. I think that is it for Thundercast this week. Special thanks, Madison, for stopping in again. You
yes.
are our most popular guests are.
I think we need to fact check that.
So if you like this podcast, you subscribe to Thundercast on iTunes, Stitcher, or wherever fine podcasts are sold. This pod was part of our 2019 Trends series, which you can download right now at thundertech.com/trends2019. And if you're dying to hear more, including topics from previous Trends publications, you can find our full library of 90-plus past episodes on our website at thundertech.com/podcasts. And if you have a topic you'd like to hear on a future Thundercast, send us a tweet at Thundertech. Thundercast is a production of Thundertech, an integrated agency for the connected world, serving clients in Cleveland, Detroit, Chicago, New York, across the nation, and around the world. Your host is me, Craig Israel. This episode was recorded, edited, and produced by Matt Stevens. Thundercast production coordinator is Shantae Rollins. Thanks for listening.